In this screencast, we're going to look at the case where you have two immiscible liquids, water and chloroform, and we're going to add a third liquid, acetone. And what we're interested in is how the acetone distributes between these two phases. And we're giving a distribution coefficient, which is the mass fraction of acetone in the chloroform phase divided by the mass fraction of acetone in the water phase. And this number is 1.72. And so the idea is we have 145 grams water, 225 grams of chloroform, and then we're going to add 55 grams of acetone. Some of the acetone is going to be in the water phase. I'll call that number grams M1, and some is going to be in the chloroform phase, M2. We're interested in solving for M2. Of course, M1 plus M2 equals 55 grams. And so we'll use that information plus this distribution coefficient, normally written as K. So remember, this is the mass fraction of acetone, and acetone in the dense phase, and acetone in the water phase, the less dense phase. That's why it's on top in the beaker. This number is 1.72, so we can calculate mass fractions. So let's write this. The numerator, I'm going to write the mass fraction of acetone. So that'd be number grams of acetone in this phase over total number of grams. Number of grams acetone in the water phase over the total number of grams of water. Those are the two mass fractions. That ratio has to be equal to 1.72. And so essentially we have two equations. M1 plus N2 has 55, and then this relation between M1 and M2 from the distribution coefficient. Two equations, two unknowns, essentially reduces to a quadratic equation that I can solve. And if I do that, I get that mass 2 is 40.8 grams. That would mean mass 1 is 14.2 grams. So the majority of acetone is in the chloroform phase, both because we have more chloroform and because the distribution coefficient favors acetone dissolving in the chloroform phase. Now, you don't need to look at the detailed calculations, but if you're interested, let's write down what these equations look like if we multiply out the equation number 2. So 1.72 times M1 plus 145 is in denominator, and then M2 on the other side. Now I can multiply this through, so let me pause and do that. So here I just made the substitution that M1 is 55 minus M2. So if I multiply this out, I'm going to end up with a quadratic equation. So I've written down the quadratic equation. I solved the quadratic equation. I end up just using the ChemE HD app that's available for phones. Makes it easy to solve quadratic equations.